everybody. Welcome to OctoOwl Plays. This time I've got Taco here with me, and he's going to play a game that I like.
Neverending Nightmares.
Neverending Nightmares. It's a spoopy, spoopy game for this spoopy, spoopy month. You want to start from the beginning?
Start from the beginning?
Yeah.
Hello.
No.
That's not normal. Oh.
Someone done got stabbed.
Well, that's a good start. It's a happy start.
This is a really good, creepy little game. And the style and the movement of everything is kind of reminiscent of old Flash games.
Yeah, it's
but
kind of a...
The guy who made this did it in kind of a Edward Gorey-esque style of cross-hatching. Like, I actually looked through his blog a little bit earlier today, and he had, like, making of posts about it. And it's basically, he'd draw out the room, and then he'd go over it again and make it look nice and clean, and then he'd do this cross-hatching stuff. And then on another layer over it, he'd have this, like, shadow effect that you see on the bottom of the screen.
Yeah.
To kind of denote that this was dark. And you'll see that your character kind of also throws a shadow, too.
Yeah, that's interesting. Yeah.
This does a really good...
Wow, that was scary.
Really good job of building atmosphere and freaking out.
Yeah, it builds
out.
Tension pretty well. I kind of... Like the little flickering lantern bits there.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of a nice touch.
Yeah.
I sort of wish that the dark, hatchy stuff
mm-hmm.
was on a loop to kind of match it.
Sort of.
It was flickering.
And I mean, you can kind of see it pulsing here.
I mean,
in the
I have
middle,
dynamic
middle
shadows,
ground.
And that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
That they're being affected by each of the torches.
Part of it is because he was using the, that's kind of foreboding, that picture right there.
Yeah.
Part of it was because he's using the Edward Gorey style, so it's kind of a slave to that. He had it to look right. And here's a Bible, and that always bodes well.
Oh, good. Psalms.
So this is predominantly...
Hobble along.
Yeah. He gets winded pretty quickly. I think you don't have a meter, but you have a sprint meter.
Seems like it.
Yeah. Colors used very sparingly, and it's only the items that you're supposed to either pay attention to, or who would paint that? Jesus.
Seriously.
Or interact with. And look, there's a... Oh, God.
Great.
This is one of my favorite games. And I heartily recommend it to people who like the scaries and the spoopies. It's a good old Halloween game to play.
It is creepy. Oh no.
God.
Is this gonna take me outside?
No, just the kitchen.
Okay. Swing the house.
Just the super not weird kitchen. I like this first area because there's not a whole lot of threats yet.
Oh.
Great.
Okay.
And there's a lot of that. There's a lot of little things happening kind of make you jump.
Well, that's the start of something.
Yep. Don't know what that is, but
it's just
juicy.
They were just cutting tomatoes.
It's fine.
It was just tomatoes.
That's all that is.
It was just tomatoes.
It's just tomatoes. It's delicious stew.
Oh, now I'm outside. This will be good.
I love the trees done in this style, though, and, like, the sort of moving bits here and there. It's a really good job. There's so much about this game I love.
Yeah, that little, like, softly tweening branch there.
Yeah.
That's fine. I like twisty trees as well.
There's a lot of depth to what's happening visually without... being overly complicated. Something tells me these were people that helped with the game. You know?
Yeah, maybe.
Gabby, no. Oh. So it's never really... Oh.
You're still sleeping? You promised we'd meet for breakfast.
Oh.
Are you okay? You look upset.
I'm sorry.
I don't normally like to have subtitles on, but I did that. I'm trying to do that when we do plays like this tonight, because I know it's kind of hard to hear what they're saying, since we have the game set lower than what we're actually saying.
It's still true, isn't it?
Yeah.
Why don't you try to get back to sleep? I'll wait outside.
I like that they have a painting of a vase.
Yeah, but not a vase. We couldn't afford one.
Yeah.
Imagine if we just had that, like pictures around the house of the things we wish we had.
I mean,
like, oh, you're gonna have to have here. Let's put a picture of a refrigerator over here on the wall. Oh, let's look at that nice picture of a hot tub.
We have a refrigerator, everybody. It's okay.
Yes.
Do they just like have a pet vulture or something?
I don't know. They like their birds.
They do like that bird.
Also, look at this tasteful skull and fruit.
I mean, that's a pretty normal still life. Also meat. Just some weird art.
Meat.
Yeah, I mean, that's kind of cool right there. I can only look at it when I'm going upwards.
Yeah. Like I said, you're only really supposed to interact with things that have the color. But everything else is there for you to observe.
So it's pretty much explore and get scared.
I mean, that's a good horror game. It doesn't have to have anything aside from that.
It is a game about never-ending nightmares? Is that...
It's literally that, yeah. It's the gentleman who made this says that it kind of illustrates, in a way, his journey with dealing with his depression.
Creepy. I don't like seeing hands coming from off-screen.
Yeah.
Like, clipped-off hands in portraits is strange.
It's just weird. Like, why couldn't I see the rest of that? Also, you're going down to the basement now, and nothing bad ever happens there.
Yeah. I'm going to the left, so I'm maybe going into memories.
There's also good use of like camera panning in this. Like it's always just a little bit too delayed. Oh.
Good. Something in the darkness got me.
Great. And I think that adds to the fear because it keeps you from seeing.
I guess I'll go right door this time.
You. Oh good. Oh good. Yes. Ah, teeth.
Good.
Ah.
Wait. Oh man, I could make a few dollars off of that. Let's get back to the pillow.
Tooth fairy wench. Unless she's the one. She's the reason that you spit them up in the first place.
Bird. Okay, I know that this is a nightmare place,
mm-hmm.
but I'm getting confused by the layout of this house.
There is no layout. It's just rooms.
I know.
It's wandering the corridors of his mind. You probably shouldn't go down into the basement.
This is gonna not.
You get too far into the dark, and it just. Well, there's a boarded up room, and that's fine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All I can do is observe it.
Yep. I think you can go up into that corner, though.
Cool. Let's go into the dark corner. The
dark blackness up there. Oh, okay.
Darkness.
Apparently, that light just does not reach around the other corner.
Okay.
It's fine.
Oh, good. A flipped photo.
Yeah, I think it was only a handful of people making this. Creepy kids' toys that are apparently looking at you disapprovingly. Like, what is those? Murder.
Gosh dang. He's on the pooper.
He's on the pooper. And there's a bear down there.
Aww. He had a bath. Cool.
See if you can interact with that veal doll right there.
Which one?
The one with the veal on her face. That one.
This here?
Yeah.
Nothing's
okay.
Nothing doing.
Okay.
Narathon.
So.
Oh.
Now there's just dolls everywhere. Great. It's great. It's good. It's fine. Dandy. Okay, you're just back at the door you went through. You went into that room
and around.
Went
that one, which led to this one. So now I go to the right. I got winded. Sorry.
Yeah.
That was something I was controlling, making the sprint. That was not...
Yeah. Your main character is Thomas, and he's
automatic.
A bit of a weenie. I can't...
That's
cool.
Oh, but it's a...
Oh,
no. I want that clock. Where do we get one of those?
This house had children in it?
Actually, we'd probably never wind it up.
I would never want that thing going off in the dead of night.
That's kind of cool.
Yeah. So when I was younger, I lived in Germany. And in Germany,
there's a thing outside.
In Germany, that doesn't happen, as far as I know. Maybe just not where I lived. But you can get cuckoo clocks really cheaply because they make them in a specific area down there where people, like, their designs are really intricate and interesting.
That would be a cuckoo Germany, right?
No.
That's why they named the clock after the town.
It's the burb.
Oh.
It's the burb, not the burg. See what I did there? It's a German joke.
I gotcha.
Anyway, mannequins.
Nothing really in here.
Mannequins and picture of peasant. Hatching. And my parents have, actually, I should say, since I don't live there anymore, a very nice cuckoo clock made out of dark wood, and it's got like a farmhouse scene
Which
under
we
it.
Go here?
I don't know. Pick one.
Let's keep going this way.
Yeah. You know, it's very woodsy and nice, and it... Oh, you got a candle.
A candle!
Yay!
Acquired candle.
I think maybe you can go into the dark areas now. Anyway.
See, like that. I like how that the hatching goes away when I'm
moving
it.
Yeah. So they do it. It's just you actually have to have a modus for it.
I gotcha.
Because the lights are so high, they don't do it for you. Long story short, we have a cuckoo clock, and it used to go off in the middle of the night and scare the shit out of me. Oh,
my
God.
Why have you forsaken me?
That's you.
That's me.
What's
That's
going
a taller
on?
Version of me.
What the dick is going on?
Oh, well, I guess I got forsaken here.
Like, that's another good thing about horror games, is you should never really give up the ghost, as it were, about what's going on too quickly. I mean, it's clear that, you know, something stinks in the state of... Oh, shit.
Great.
State
Ambient
of Denmark.
Ambient sound is intensifying.
It's good sound design in this game, too.
Let's go in here. It won't be a mistake, I'm sure.
No? Looks like you're fine.
Mannequins.
That one has a sewing or patching needle embedded in it. That's not weird.
No. Not at all.
I feel like it got darker.
Yeah, it wasn't this dark before.
Good.
Also, it had window before.
Yeah. Oh,
no,
it's raining. I see. It's storming. That's cool. I like that, how it denotes
that. Cool. They're able to do a lot of storytelling with just some things overlaid this hallway. I like that. It's efficient.
Don't huff like that, dude. You're gonna blow your candle out.
That's a good point.
And whatever the hell it is skulking around out there, better fucking stop it.
I didn't pay
attention. What was I saying about the cuckoo clock?
They had one.
Oh yeah.
That's pretty much all you were saying.
Yeah, we had one. It went off in the middle of the night sometimes, scared the shit out of me. And it wasn't, like, ominous or anything. Oh, that one's moving by itself. It wasn't ominous or anything. It just did it. And it was just creepy. There's just something about clocks going off when you're trying to sleep. Did any of your relatives have big ominous grandfather or cuckoo clocks?
Not especially. My parents had like a clock in the living room on the mantle that's was
flowers
really scary
are all
or
fucked up now.
They can go down here now that I have light.
Yeah, the flowers are all wilted now.
They are.
I mean, was there anything in any of your relatives' houses that you remember being like, this is a creepy thing and I don't want anything to do with it?
I mean, just the ghosts, my cousins.
The ghosts.
The ghosts. I told you about that, right?
I think you did.
Your neighbor's house was supposed to be haunted.
Right.
So it's kind of
thing about a blood stain too, I think.
They had like a blood stain in the house that wouldn't go away when they cleaned it.
Those are always fun. It's just like you know some shit happened here, but you don't know exactly what. Great, now go back out. Oh, good. Get the fuck out of there. You can't have it back. You can only carry one thing. Oh Jesus balls.
Okay.
I'm gonna have to put a warning on this video.
That's great. Oh look, but I have an axe in my room.
With blood on it for no reason.
I can explain everything.
It's fine.
I can't explain anything.
No.
I just have it though, right? Like, yeah.
It's just yours now. Yeah.
Well, I'm gonna go up this time.
I like that he very gently puts it against his arm when you go outdoors. He's being very careful with this huge hatchet with blood all over it. That's not good.
So what else do you think is effective about this game in terms of horror and atmosphere and all that?
The fact that it's so simple. And that so many of the things that get activated, as it were, happen just after you'd expect them to. Or they don't... It's not something that you're affecting at all. So, like the forms moving past the window lights.
Mm-hmm.
It's just there. It's never explained. It's not told you why it's happening. It's just there to build up the uneasiness that you feel.
I see. I can break these.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess I do have reason to go back the other path.
Well, you're going upstairs now, it looks like.
That's good. It's always a good idea.
Upstairs and downstairs. Generally, going anywhere but the floor that you are on to begin with.
I'll leave the floor that touches the ground. That exits to the ground.
Seems to be a bad idea in horror stuff. Oh, no.
I'm not going to comment on this. Oh, okay. Alright.
Now the house is kind of dilapidated.
It sure is. I don't have an axe anymore, so I can't go the other way. Guess we'll never know what was in there. Sorry, everyone.
Well, I mean, you could always play it yourself. Play it again.
Yes, you can.
It's,
You can, in fact, get this game on Steam!
Yeah, you can. It's on Steam. I don't know where else you can get it. I think you might be able to get it from his website. But this game has branching paths, so it actually has a couple different endings.
Okay.
And I don't necessarily know what affects the branching paths, too, so I couldn't be like... I couldn't tell you if it's like you went in the wrong door at the wrong time, or you didn't find this thing. It's anything, really. Mm, okay.
Something with color.
Eh. Creepy.
Okay.
I don't like that there's a nun doll right next to it.
Yeah.
I just don't like creepy toys laying around.
Good, screeching.
Great. Somebody.
Music is intensifying.
Yeah.
This place either got shitty or someone just wrecked this house.
Someone just wrecked this house.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm sure that'll be important.
It will. It's good that you found out that you can do this. It does that really well, too, like illustrating the things that you're able to do.
To interact with?
Mm-hmm. Before you have to use them for, like, panic mode.
I see.
Which, considering the pace of the game, is good. It's another thing that I think a lot of horror games need to kind of get up on, is that you need some moments of not necessarily peace, but downtime between the fright. Because if you're ramped up the entire time, eventually you kind of stop being affected by it.
Right.
But if you're allowed a few moments to kind of stop and get, like, there's another doll over there that you can interact with. If you're allowed a couple of minutes to just breathe.
Yeah, that's gotta be hard.
What is these soulless dead eyes, Jesus?
Because you need to deliver a scare within like a single sitting or something.
Mm-hmm.
So that's gotta be kind of hard to figure out and balance, I imagine.
Man. I think that's why narrative-based games work better, because you have the drive to keep going is mainly the
mystery.
That
doll blinked.
Oh no. You're not supposed to have a face that moves. That one has a broken face, and it's staring at the camera.
It's in the same position. I don't like that.
And it's judging me, and I don't like it.
I don't know if there's a term for that kind of creepy cut thing, where
just something that was in the room previous is in the exact same position in the next room.
Yeah, like per the frame, so that your eye is still seeing it.
I don't know. That's a good question. Don't take whatever that creepy photo is offering you.
I will not.
Doesn't know what you want. It's with all the freaky dolls without the eyes. What's going on here with this?
I don't like it.
I don't like it at all.
I'm gonna slowly jog from it.
Don't wind yourself too quickly.
I said big babu! I don't know where it went.
He's sniffing you out. That's gross. That's gross.
It's a big gross thing. His veins are all blue.
Oh no, he knows where you are.
Oh, no.
He knows where you are.
I'm not in here. Nothing to worry about. There you go. Baby, go bye-bye.
Oh, peace.
Out of here.
Yeah, that was a little terrifying. I don't think I like that. And I've actually already played up till this point before, so... It's good that it affects you the same way. Each time. That you're just like, fuck that noise.
Well, I guess my path is settled for me.
I think you already went around the other end. Like, you've
seen
that part.
You're right.
But yeah, that's effective too. As long as you're not exposed to backtrack a whole bunch, having kind of confusing maze-like structure is okay. This game does a good job of kind of leading you around and making you confused about where you came from without making you have to go
check
back and, like, get things, basically.
Yeah.
And you are a weenie, Thomas. Well, we will see what's going on in this nightmarish hellscape next time on OctoOwl Plays.
Next time.
Bye-bye.
See ya.